write on thermodynamic equilibrium.
Sir?
Yes?
The graph is valid only for safe function.
No, no, what I was trying to explain here, that if you are at point A, and if you are coming to this point B, you can have many paths possible like this. But when you are at this point B, your pressure will be P2, V2 and T2 only, irrespective of the path followed. So that's why pressure, volume, temperature is a state function. It depends upon initial and final state, not the path followed to gain this state. Okay? But work, if you see, suppose work example, if you take this path is small, right? So here, if you come here to here by this path, work done will be less. But if you follow this path, work done will be more, right? So work done is what? Work done is path function. It depends on the path we choose. Right? So that's why the path function is what? Anything that is related to work or energy, that's what we have. Right? Next slide on thermodynamic. Thermodynamic equilibrium. What is thermodynamic equilibrium? Write down. When a system is at thermal, chemical, and mechanical equilibrium. Thermal, chemical, and mechanical equilibrium. Then it is said to be in thermodynamic equilibrium. All three equilibrium are there. Then it is thermodynamic equilibrium, right? When the system is at thermal, chemical, and mechanical equilibrium, it is said to be in thermodynamic equilibrium.
So mechanical as in it's not moving, like nothing inside.
Mechanical means when the pressure is same. Two side, if you are applying the same pressure, yeah, it's not moving. Suppose you have an object, you are applying the same pressure. Okay, so it won't move. That is mechanical equilibrium. Chemical equilibrium means what? When concentration is same both sides.
So if I have a top spinning and...
What?
If I have like a top that's spinning, but it's a chemical and thermal equilibrium, then...
So that is, see, when you have a top spinning, right? So there is no translatory motion into this. There's a circular motion on its own axis. Right? But the point is, you have an object. I'm trying to explain what is mechanical equilibrium. You have an object like this. Okay? If you apply some force from this direction, which is nothing but, okay, you're applying some force from this side and the same force from this side. Right? Then these two will cancel out each other. Right? So this is in mechanical equilibrium.
So then any object that's moving is not in thermal equilibrium?
Not in thermal equilibrium, yes. Not in thermodynamic equilibrium. Thermal equilibrium is when temperature is same both sides.
So the velocity is constant, force spread here and here is same.
What? When the equal force is there, there's no movement into this. There's no net force.
The velocity is constant.
Velocity is constant means what? There's no acceleration. Any constant acceleration motion we have, no? Constant acceleration motion is possible. An object can move with a constant acceleration. It's possible. So that is not thermodynamic. That is not mechanical equilibrium. When net force, simply one thing you keep in mind. When net force is zero, there is no net movement. Then it is mechanical
equilibrium.
Constant velocity means acceleration zero. Right? So when there is no acceleration, then you can say, yeah, it's fine. That's fine. Point is, mechanical equilibrium, when net force is zero, F net is zero. Chemical equilibrium, when I say, it means chemical equilibrium is when concentration is zero. There is no net concentration. And when we say, what is the next one? Mechanical, chemical and thermodynamic equilibrium. Thermal. Thermal equilibrium is what? When temperature is constant, delta T is equal to zero. Temperature is not there. So when all these three types of equilibrium we have, then it is said to be thermodynamic equilibrium. Right? One more thing you can say, thermodynamic equilibrium is defined, write down. Thermodynamic equilibrium is defined.
Concentration.
Chemical equilibrium means what?
Change in concentration.
So that's why, when concentration is zero both sides, delta C right now. Concentration must be same both sides. Okay? Thermodynamic, write down. It is. What did you write? What is the first line you
wrote?
It is also defined as the state where all the state variable is fixed. There is no change in the state variable. right? In thermodynamics, we always deal with the system which is in thermodynamic equilibrium. Always deals with the system which is in thermodynamic equilibrium. Okay. Next, write down thermodynamic process. We are just looking at the different terms now. Thermodynamic process. Write down into this. Write down, it is the path by which thermodynamic process. It is a path by which a system is path by which a system is changing its state. Okay, the various different process you write down: isothermal in bracket, just in short write down in bracket, constant temperature, isobaric, constant pressure, isochoric, constant volume, isochoric, adiabatic, there is no exchange of heat, delta Q is zero. For adiabatic, delta Q is equals to zero. No exchange of heat in this. Okay, and we also call it as isoentropic. Isoentropic process. Entropy will also be constant into this. When delta Q is zero, entropy won't change. That we'll discuss later. Entropy we'll see after second law of thermodynamics. Okay. Isoentropic we also call it as. Next, write down adiabatic ho gaya, and then cyclic process. What is cyclic process?
Starts and ends in the same state.
Initial and final state will be same. Okay? Initial and final state will be same. This is an cyclic process. We start from A, goes here, B, and then C, and then D, and then E. Okay? So cyclic process, initial and final state is same. That depends. It's not necessary. That depends.
So our same difference are isoentropic. So like say if one of them underwent radioactive decay, then it will give out another particle and change the rate of entropy.
No, I'm talking about delta Q is equals to zero. Heat exchange will be zero. Then it is isoentropic. No, not delta T.
So I said if one of the particles inside your system underwent radioactive decay, it will give out another particle and change the entropy.
What entropy will change? Entropy of system will change. So if the system entropy decreases, surroundings entropy will increase by the same value.
So the system entropy will increase.
Whatever, if one changes, system entropy, if it is decreasing by the same amount, the surroundings entropy will increase. And radioactive decay we are not considering. That is a very rare case. So radioactivity we are not considering. So anyways, we can write the system, if you have, it is isoentropic when delta Q is equal to zero. Radioactive decay we are not considering into this. But again, if you are considering radioactive decay, system entropy decreases by the same amount, surrounding entropy increases. The delta S of the total system of the universe will be what? Zero in that case. One decreases, other increases. So delta S will be zero. Okay, so entropy we'll discuss it later. One very important thing here, cyclic process, we have initial and final state is same. Right? So if you find out the change in all the state function, what is the state function? Any example? Delta U. Delta in internal energy is a state function. Yeah, delta U. So what is delta U in a cyclic process? Delta U is what? Change in C. If you have first A and B. If it goes to A and B like this, here the internal energy is UA and here it is UB. So what is delta U? Delta U will be UB minus UA, or magnitude if you are considering, it is the difference we have. So since we have cyclic process, so all the state function since it does not depend upon the path followed to gain that state. So the change in all the state function will be 0. So delta U will be 0, delta G will be 0, delta P will be 0, delta T will be 0, delta H will be 0, delta S will be 0. All these things will be 0. Delta T will be 0, P, delta B, right? Delta B also will be 0. So change in state function in cyclic process will always be 0. It's very important point this one. Okay. See, sometimes the conversion of graph is important and you need to do this while solving problem. Suppose you see this graph, we have pressure and volume. A, B, and C. This is the graph we have. It is given. Now you need to convert this into PV graph. Sorry, it is PV given. So you need to convert this into PT and you need to convert this into PT, I think. PT. Just a second. PV. PT. PV. PT. It is PT. It is PT. It is PV. So this graph is given. You need to convert this into PV graph.
What?
You have
to convert what?
This graph, you need to convert into PV graph. Suppose it is given. How do we convert this into PV graph? And this into PT. Okay.
It's
work
if you take
negative
pressure.
They're all the same.
What is the same? See, first of all, it's important QF. You know, PV graph, you know, work done, when calculate the PV graph, what do you do? Area under the curve. You know, work done in PV graph is what? Area under the curve, right? So sometimes if PV graph is given, you can find out the area that will be the work done. You, magnitude you can get easily. But sometimes they'll give you PT graph and work done, suppose you need to find out. So this area we cannot find out to get the work done. Right? But work done part we'll see later on. But you see, from this graph, can you tell me what is this process A to B? What process is this? Achha, AB last mein karte hain. A to C batao kya hai? A to C kya hai? Constant pressure. Isobaric, right? It is isobaric. What is B to C? Iso? Thermal. Then you tell you what is A to B?
Isochoric.
It is isochoric because you see this graph is touching this origin. So it is a straight line like this, which is a constant volume only. PT graph at constant volume passes through origin. Okay, states of matter mein kya tha? ठीक है, A to B is what? Isochoric. Now can you do this? Isochoric means volume constant.
Right?
Suppose A to B is this. Volume constant. So A to B. And then isobaric is A to C. A to C is this, suppose. And B to C is isothermal. So isothermal is what? At constant pressure? So at temperature, which is this. So this is A, this is C, and this is B. A to B, B to C, and C to B.
And under this, you get
work. See, this is, suppose B to C kya hai? Isothermal hai. So isothermal graph kaisa hoga? PV graph. Constant temperature pe aisa graph hoga. A to B to C. A to B kya hoga? Toh constant volume, isochoric. C to A constant pressure, isobaric. Wahi to hai. Which way? Acha, waise bhi ho sakta hai. Next time. A to B, pressure is increasing. A to B, pressure is increasing. If you do like this, that is B to A, pressure decreases. Can you do this V to V T graph? Try this V T graph once. V T graph, you tell me. So isochronic is A to B. So this is suppose A to B graph we have. B to C is isothermal. So B to C is isothermal. And C to A is isobaric. Isobaric is constant pressure, right? So in galti kar gaya maine. Constant pressure will be this, right? And we'll have this.
So why the direction
is that?
So why
is
the
direction? B to C, pressure decreases, right? B to C, pressure decreases, and B to C is isothermal process. So B to C,
as pressure decreases, volume should
be. Let me write this first. A to B is what? Isochronic. A to B is isochronic.
B and C should be switched.
So will B will have. I made some mistake. BC is isothermal. So this is B and this is C. And AB is isothermal. Now it's fine. Again. So A to B is this isochronic. C to C is isothermal. And C to A is isobaric. Okay. Sometimes they ask you this conversion in question also. They give you one graph corresponding to this. What is VT graph? Because if it is VT graph you are drawing, so at constant pressure the line must pass through origin. Y is equals to mx. VT PV is equals to what? NRT. VT graph, if we draw, so constant pressure VS must pass through. Okay.